교회 여러분, 요즘 잘 지내시죠? 날씨가 낮에는 좋지만 아침에 저녁엔 좀 쌀쌀한 것 같아요. 늘 건강 조심하시고, 또 이번 주 금요일하고 토요일 날 또 이강원 목사님 오시는 거 잊지 마시고 다 참석해 주시고요. 오늘 벤송 전도사님 말씀 전해 주실 때 예배에 대해서 전해 주시는데 모두 은혜 받는 시간 되시길 바랍니다. 함께 찬양 드리시고 말씀 묵상하겠습니다.
22장 5절 말씀입니다. 이에 아브라함이 종들에게 이르되 너희는 나귀와 함께 여기서 기다리라. 내가 아이와 함께 저기 가서 예배하고 우리가 너희에게로 돌아오리라 하고. 아멘.
This morning I want to talk about worship. So often our worship can be determined by our external circumstances. How we worship is dependent on why we worship, and why we worship can be influenced by so many other things than God Himself. It's not hard to imagine that there can be times when we are in the act of worshiping God, but what appears to be worship to us and to others is in fact something different to God. There's a story in the book of Leviticus where the sons of Aaron, who were serving as priests at the time, were offering incense to God. But instead of using the right ingredients, they used something different. The way that Moses described it in Leviticus chapter 10 verse 1 is that they offered strange fire before the Lord. And when God recognized what they had done, it says that fire came out from before the Lord, and they died right then and there. What we know about Nadab and Abihu is that it wasn't just the fact that they made a mistake in mixing the ingredients for the incense they were to offer up to God, but that what they offered was evidence of the lack of reverence that they had in their hearts toward God. They had lost the meaning of what it meant to worship the holy God of Israel. Well, in our passage this morning, we see a different example of worship. We come to the familiar story of when God asked Abraham to sacrifice his one and only son, Isaac. We know that Abraham had another son through Sarah's servant Hagar. However, Isaac was the one that God had promised to Abraham, and that it would be from Isaac that God's promises to Abraham would be fulfilled. And though Abraham had proven his faithfulness to God up until this point, by leaving his family in Haran and going to the place that God had led him to, God wanted to test Abraham once again. And he did this by telling Abraham to go to the place where God would show him and to make a sacrifice to God there with his son Isaac. Just by reading this story, we can't fully know and understand what was going on in Abraham's heart and mind. But it's not hard to imagine that this would not have been an easy decision for Abraham to make. Up until the very moment Abraham raised his knife above his son, there's no doubt in my mind that Abraham's heart was heavy every step of the way. But in our passage today, we get a glimpse into Abraham's heart when he spoke to his servants to give them instructions. And what he said to them was, I and the boy will go over there to worship. The Hebrew word used here for worship literally means to bow down. Though Abraham was given such a difficult assignment by God, what we see from Abraham's words to his servants is that he still carried reverence to God in his heart, despite his circumstances. He considered what God had asked him to do as an act of worship because of who it was he was doing it for. Now, we may not be asked by God to carry out such a task like Abraham did with Isaac, but whether big or small, sacrifices involve so much more of our will than anything else we do in life. But whether it's our time or our money, our dreams or our ambitions, whatever we feel led to sacrifice, may we do it with a heart of reverence, a heart of worship, because of who it is we are doing it for.
네, 전도사님 오늘 말씀 감사합니다. 오늘 예배에 대해 말씀해 주셨는데 우리가 여러 가지 모양으로 여러 가지 방법으로 예배를 드릴 수 있는데 가장 핵심은 우리 마음속에 하나님을 경외하는 마음이 있는가를 강조하셨어요. 그 예로 아론의 아들들, 제사장들은 그 하나님께서 원치 않은 불을, 잘못된 불을 사용함으로써 벌을 받아 죽었죠. 그 마음속에는 경외함이 없었다고 했죠. 그리고 두 번째는 가장 귀한 아들, 아브라함이 이삭을 바치면서 드리는 그 예배, 그 제사를 예를 드시면서 그 마음속에는 하나님을 진정 경외하는 마음이 있었다고 말씀하셨는데 오늘 우리들이 사는 이 삶도 매분 매 시간 매일이 하나님께 드리는 예배의 시간이지 않습니까? 그래서 우리들도 하나님을 항상 경외해야 되는데 오늘 우리가 묵상할 말씀은 우리가 얼마만큼 그리고 진정 하나님을 경외하는 마음 속이 경외하는 마음이 얼마나 있는가 다시 한번 생각해보는 저와 여러분이 되기를 바랍니다. 그래서 오늘 묵상하실 때 정말 우리 마음속에 어느 사탄마귀도 틈타지 못하는 그런 하나님을 경외하는 마음으로 우리가 삶을 살아가고 있는지 그런 시간이 묵상하는 시간이 됐으면 좋겠습니다. 함께 기도하겠습니다. 고마우신 하나님, 또 저희에게 또 이번 주 공동의회를 앞두고 있는 우리 교우들에게 오늘 진정 예배가 어떻게 드려야 되는지 또 예배의 가장 핵심은 무엇인지를 대해서 다시 생각하게 해주셔서 감사합니다. 우리가 진정 하나님을 경외하는 그 마음, 하나님을 경외하는 그 마음으로 진정 매 시간 하루를 살아가는 우리들 되게 하시고 또 예배에 임하는 우리들로 준비시켜 주시기를 간절히 원하며 오늘 하루를 온전히 주님께 맡겨오며 예수님 귀하신 이름으로 기도드립니다. 아멘. 여러분, 오늘 진정 하나님을 경외하는 마음이 가장 이렇게 우선인 여러분과 제가 되기를 소원하며 또 하루 승리하시길 바랍니다. 또 내일 뵙겠습니다.